So this is Dr. Alejandro Badia. We're going to be having a dialogue today about something extremely common in the field of hand surgery, which is problems with the basal joint of the thumb, which is really where your thumb meets the wrist.
Okay, so Dr. Badia, if someone came in today suffering from thumb basal joint arthritis, how would you treat it?
Well, first we determine the stage of arthritis. We would get plain x-rays, and we always start with conservative treatment in virtually all cases. Unless, of course, many of the patients have already had ample treatment before coming to see somebody like myself. We would use splinting, we would use anti-inflammatories, we do corticosteroid injections into the joint, usually just one, maybe two, and I do that with ultrasound or fluoroscopic guidance to make sure that the needle actually enters the joint, which is at this location. If those have failed, then we start talking about surgical options.
Okay. And what role does the CMC joint play in a patient's grip and pinch strength?
Yeah, this is most critical for a pinch. When you think about it, as you apply this force to turn a key or to pick something up, you need to have the base of the thumb to be very stable, strong, and non-painful. In fact, the forces reflected at the base of the thumb are about 10 times what you apply at the tip. So you can imagine that they're amplified, and those are studies that have shown that, and it also affects your grip strength. So this can be very disabling if you ask somebody who's suffering from this.
Okay. And if the patient was considering surgery, what would be your recommendations?
Well, there's many options, so it depends on the stage and depends on their particular needs. I will tell you the vast majority of the patients that I see who need surgery, I will do arthroscopic, meaning with two little holes, without even a stitch, I will introduce about approximately 2.5 millimeter arthroscope or camera into the joint and resolve the issue many times that way. However, in patients a bit older, or depending on what their needs are, I am now doing a joint replacement, which is a much faster recovery, basically no period of immobilization. And the implant I'm currently using is called BioPro. So it's basically replacing half of the joint right where the metacarpal meets a trapezial bone, and to eliminate that painful grinding. And that is about a 30-minute procedure.
Okay, and in your professional opinion, what are the benefits of joint replacement versus an LRTI or suspension procedure?
Yeah, the classic operation that patients hear from their hand surgeon is where you have a complete excision of the trapezium, meaning you're taking out this entire carpal bone. You can imagine not only is that painful, but you burn some bridges. If that doesn't go well, the options after that are very difficult to revise. So that is called LRTI, ligament reconstruction tendon interposition. That is an acronym for an operation that was described nearly 50 years ago. And ironically, we haven't advanced much past that. And yet there are implants out there that have been used in Europe and other places with very good results as long as you have good patient selection. So the advantages are just ease of recovery, a much faster recovery, basically no immobilization, minimal amount of post-op pain in my experience, and I think a better option for the right patient.
Okay. And what factors can affect the type of treatment you recommend to your patients?
I think the main thing is activity level and age. So a patient, even if they're fairly active in their mid-70s, is different than somebody in their early 40s. But those are that's the spectrum of patients who suffer from this. So it really depends on what their needs are. If patients are interested in a very fast recovery and they're not doing mountain climbing or something, then they are a great option for this joint replacement. And I've even done this on people who golf and do other sports, as long as they do, they are aware and they protect it to some degree. Mm-hmm. So I think that it's important for patients to understand the options. Be careful what you read on the internet. There's a lot of nonsense out there. Make sure you look at the source. It really needs to be somebody who is a hand specialist and understand that there are other options out there. It's not simply the traditional operation of just removing the trapezium. There are other good surgical options.
Thank you, Dr. Badia.
Thanks.